So, precious ones, I just wanted to leave that with you. And then the other thing I wanted to bring out to you is that that the Spirit Himself bears witness with our spirit that we're a child of God. It says, you know, that if we don't have the Spirit, we're none of His. You say, well, what is the Spirit? It's the quickening power from heaven that quickens your soul and bears witness with your soul that you are a child of the living God. So when I say to people, I say, you know, we have in the scriptures where in Colossians 2:13, let's turn over there real quick. Colossians 2:13, it says that you being dead in your sins, I remember when I came to the Lord, I didn't know there was any such thing as Jesus is real. That the Lord is real and that you can feel the real Lord Jesus. And so many people nowadays are putting down feelings. You know, we're not a robot. First of all, we're not AI intelligence, artificial intelligence. We are those whose hearts and souls and minds have been quickened and changed. I had a changed mind as soon as God's spirit was made real to me by His Holy Spirit. So it says here in the 13th verse of Colossians 2, it says, you are dead in your sin. I was like, I was walking through this world, but without Christ, I did not know reality as reality really is. It was like my eyes all of a sudden saw the world I was even in, because you're dead in your trespasses and sins, and you cannot see that with your spiritual eyes because they've been blinded by our sin. Amen. And so it says here, you are dead in your sin and the uncircumcision of your flesh, but he has quickened together with Him, having forgiven you all your trespasses, not just one trespass, precious ones, but all, even the ones you don't know about. He was the fivefold gifting of grace in the Old Testament, all those sacrifices, all five, you know, and it says there was one that was for promiscuous sins that some of them we weren't even aware they were sins, because this flesh, sometimes we don't even see when there's someone hurting because our eyes are blinded with selfishness. We don't see that because we're walking through this world with darkened spiritual eyes. We're like blind people walking through this world in the sins that beset us all. You know, there's not one of us. There's none good. No, not one. There's not one person out there that's perfect. There was only one perfect one, the only begotten Son of God. So he says here, he's quickened us, quickened us. Well, when the Holy Spirit comes in and you begin to feel that love on your soul of sins forgiven and you're free from everything that had you bound. When you feel that presence, you know, and you feel that love that, you know, you've longed for, even as the woman that wept at Jesus' feet. And she came in and her tears were so copious that she just flooded His feet to wash His feet because of adoration filled her heart. Because no doubt many, many times there had been hurt and things in her life that just burdened her heart, broke her heart. And you know what? There was a song they used to sing that, you know, it was good for me, you know, that my heart was broken. It was good for you that God had to come and wash your eyes with tears. And He had to break your heart so He'd have your heart forever. So if any of you are out there and you've had a broken heart, maybe you've had a lot of broken relationships. We're living in an hour when so many people are living in broken relationships or relationships that have absolutely crushed them. But you know what? There's a healer for your soul. So won't you call on Him today, Jesus, the mighty healer of our souls. And the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you. It will quicken you. It will heal all those scars, all those wounds that are deep that nobody sees. So God will come and heal you today. And remember, Jesus is coming soon. You're not saved. You know, call on him today, because he will quicken you with his spirit, and he will hold you close to his heart and heal you. So I encourage you to do that today. And you can do it right in your home. You know, the Lord is just a prayer away. So anyway, just come to him with all that you are. Hide nothing from the Lord, because he sees down deep in you. He sees everything you need. So, and also, I wanted to go to a couple other scriptures. The quickening of the spirit. And it says in Romans 8:8, it says, so then, if we're in the flesh, we can't please God. But you are not in the flesh, but you're in the spirit, if the spirit of God dwells in you. Now, if any man has not the spirit of Christ, he's none of his. If Christ be in you, the body's dead because of sin, but the spirit is life because of his righteousness. But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he that raised Christ from the dead shall, and here's the word today for you, quicken your mortal body, and by his spirit that dwells in you. Don't be afraid of the Holy Spirit. Be quickened by his might and his power, because it'll give you power over all the power of the evil one that tries to hold you in bondage of any faults, any sins that that beset you. So anyway, I want to give you that word today. And also, I wanted to give you a great word from the scriptures, a few of them, just to bless you. And you say, well, you know what? I don't think any man knew the depths of other than Abraham, maybe, was, and Isaiah and some of the great prophets, but King David, such a warrior for the Lord, and yet probably the most tender man that we read after in the Psalms. More Psalms, more songs to the Lord out of his soul came, because he was a man that really was emotional. You read how he talks about he wet his bed. He just wet his pillow with tears. Honey, you're going to have to take that out. He wet his bed with tears. Take that out. So anyway, I wanted to read you these scriptures from King David and many of these songs that he sang from his soul. Psalms 119, verse 25. He says, my soul cleaves unto the dust. Quicken thou me according to thy word. David had to run for 12 years from Saul, from a cave to a crown. So sometimes we'll be suffering for the Lord. And with all the things that are going on in the world, none of us knows what tomorrow holds, because God's shaking this earth once again. And so that's one thing to encourage yourself with. Another scripture, he says, Psalms 119, and he says in the 37th verse, turn away my eyes from beholding vanities, and quicken thou me in the way. Because we need to be... That's when you feel quickened by the Spirit, and God's Spirit and presence comes to help you, to quicken you in the way that you're taking, and to lead you, and to make you to know the way in which you should walk. And he says also, behold, I have longed after your precepts or your ways. Quicken me in thy righteousness. So it's God's righteousness that'll quicken us, and it's his Spirit that will do the work. Because if you'll yield your members, your flesh, to the blessings of God and the power, let that power, lift up your hands if you're alone today. Just lift up your hands. David said, taste and see that the Lord is good. Sometimes you need to taste something for yourself to see how good it is. So lift up your hands to the living God. Close your eyes and say, Lord, I need to feel your presence. I need to feel that strength. I need to feel your presence, because there's such a war on, and I hear a lot of preachers say, oh, you can't go by feeling, you can't go by feeling. I'm one day I'm so glad I felt God's presence, and his loving arms surround me, and I knew for the first time Jesus was real. So you know what? I'm glad I feel the Lord. I feel the Lord while I'm talking to you, because we need someone greater, greater than ourselves and our sorrow and our troubles, and it's Jesus. Amen. So,